Now let's see a question, which is like the features of the Booth algorithm, can be asked. So the features of Booth algorithm is that it handles I mean spelling, my God, H-A-N-D-L-E-S. Okay, welcome here. Okay, so handles the positive and negative multipliers uniformly. So we have seen it right here now. The negative number also we can multiply using Booth algorithm. Before you could not do that. Here we can do positive and negative multipliers. So that's the first point. The second one is it achieves some more efficiency when the multiplier has a few large blocks of ones in it. What does it mean by that? Well, you remember, why did we take this Booth algorithm? The very reason for us to take the Booth algorithm was that we needed less number of partial products. When do we have less number of partial products? When zeros comes here. When 0 into m, when it comes, then zeros comes here. It is easier to add it, right? When it's zeros here. So like that, we can reduce the number of partial products. Here, it's only 1, 2, 3. 3 partial products. This and this, we won't count because it's all zeros. So just like that, we need to reduce the number of partial products. So here, when there are a few large blocks of 1, see what happens. 0 minus 1, 0, 0 we'll append here. 0 minus 0, 0. 0 minus 1, minus 1. 1 minus 1, 0. 1 minus 1, 0. You see, many zeros are coming here. 1 minus 0, plus 1. 0 minus 1, minus 1. Then these two, 1 minus 1, 0, 1 minus 1, 0. So see, you'll get few blocks of zeros here. These all will not be counted partial products. So here, how many partial products will be there in this case? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. 10 partial products will be there. What about in this case? Only this one, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Only 5 partial products. So that's how it reduces the number of partial products. Now, let us see a case in which the worst case multiplier, when will it come? The worst case multiplier is when the normal multiplication has lesser number of partial products than the Booth algorithm. When does it happen? It does happen. So let's say the multiplier that we got is this one. Okay, 0 minus 1 minus 1, 1 minus 0 1, 0 minus 1 minus 1, like that it will go. So here the number of partial products, these are zeros, right? We count only the ones. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. 7 partial products are there. That's for normal multiplication. And the Booth multiplication, how many do we have? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. According to that, it's 13 partial products. So the Booth algorithm has more partial products than 7, than the normal multiplication. So that creates the worst case multiplier. And the Booth algorithm is not as efficient as it should be. Okay. So what is a good Booth multiplier? Well, a Booth multiplier works best when you have a few consecutive blocks of ones. What happens when there is a few consecutive blocks of 1? These 1 minus 1, 0. 1 minus 1, 0. 1 minus 1, 0. All these consecutive ones will create zeros. See, consecutive ones, zeros. All these zeros will create no partial products. So, see, here when there's 15 partial products for these ones, here only, here and there some 1 and minus 1 is there, which is just 6 partial products. Look at the difference. In normal multiplication, you will have to add 15 partial products. Here you just add 6 partial products. That is a hell lot of a difference. So that is an example for a good Booth multiplier. Okay.